Coming to you live from the On Access Studios of beautiful downtown Torrance, it's the Quarantine Comedy Show, featuring the casting directors and musical guest Renegade, and our weekly news roundup with Renee Piercy, and now the host of the Quarantine Comedy Show, Tom Kearney.
Hello? Are we rolling? Welcome back to the Quarantine Comedy Show. I'm your host, Tom Kearney, and yeah, we had another week. Everybody doing okay out there? Well, we had Halloween. Last night was election night. That happened. But we still don't know what's going on. We have no idea what's going on. And I'm fed up with it. I'm watching TV nonstop. It's like a drug. It's like a telethon that never ends, you know? And I don't know about you, but I don't think it's a healthy thing. It's ruining my life. And then I realized that this isn't a healthy situation. And then I break up with it, you know? And I try to explain it. I'm like, look, it's not you, it's me. I just think I should be watching other shows. And then I click off and I'm like, a couple of minutes go by and then I go back and I take her back. But then I forgot what a terrible person she was and why I broke up with her in the first place. It's crazy. It's crazy. I feel like I'm at a restaurant trying to order a meal that is gonna last 4 years. You know? It's like, yeah. Oh, gosh, I don't know. I'd really like the chicken wings, you know, those spicy wings, but they give me acid reflux and I throw up and then, you know, I get real gassy and, you know, I don't know. Maybe I should have the Caesar salad, you think? You know, it's healthy, right? So it's good for my environment, you know? I don't know. I think we're looking for salad in all the wrong places. Kale Caesar. My buddy Rick told me that. I don't know what it means, but I thought it was funny. Oh, my God. So did you hear about this? There was a Gallup poll recently done where they asked 1,000 women if they would have sex with Donald Trump. Seriously. They did this. They spent money on this. They spent like $130,000, well, just about as much Stormy Daniels was paid. So they asked these women, okay, so 1% said no, 2% said yes, and then 97% said never again. It's crazy. Yeah, we don't know who the president is. Of course, Trump came out and declared himself the winner. Of course he did. Oh, it's crazy. Let's just stay calm and be cool, folks. We just had Halloween, very uneventful. We had no trick-or-treaters, but we did have two drones. Yeah, two drones came and they knocked at the front door like ding dong. Zzz, happy Halloween, trick-or-treat. Zzz. I'm like, wow, what are you? I'm a ghost. Zzz. Really? I'm not buying that. Seriously, that's what it's come down to. Drones. Drones are our future. That's where it's all going to be. Amazon's going to be delivering with drones, right? Right? In fact, I heard that they're actually going to be taking orders with drones as well. Can you imagine? They're going to be at your door. They're going to be looking in your windows. They're going to be like, I see you have company over tonight. Can I interest you in some curtains? It's going to get out of hand. That's the world we live in, folks. That's it in a nutshell. And I do mean nut. Oh, it's crazy. It's crazy. Yeah, drones are the future. I had a bit of a moment with drones. I was going to be like the Top Gun pilot of drones. I was like, you know, I was like really into it. I had the goggles, you know, and I'd be out there and I'd be with my phone with the goggles and I'd be flying it around. And then it got stuck in a tree. And I was like, God, I was like, son of a, God damn it. And it was up there. That was the day I lost $1,000. It wasn't the worst day of my life, but it was up there. Folks, we have a fantastic show for you today. We have the casting directors back by popular demand and musical guest Renegade out of Boston. But before we get started, here's our very own Renee Percy with our weekly news roundup. Renee, what the heck is going on out there? Can you run it down for us?
I'm Renee Percy, and welcome to a special Election Day edition of... Today is Election Day, and Trump has tried every voter suppression effort in the book, claiming that his fear is that this election will be decided by Americans. The White House has erected a giant fence around its perimeter, and businesses are boarding up their windows. Make America great again? The only thing he has made great again is Home Depot! Trump left supporters stranded in the cold for hours after his rally in Pennsylvania, just days after a similar debacle in Omaha sent several people to the hospital for hypothermia. One way or another, Trump seems intent on turning his supporters blue. Trump promises that he has a plan to get his supporters safely back to their cars after rallies, but like all his other plans, he won't reveal it until after the election. A Stanford study has linked over 30,000 confirmed coronavirus cases and 700 deaths to Trump rallies. When asked to comment, Trump said, "No, fast enough. Let's freeze them to death." Enough about him. Hopefully, after today, we will only ever utter his name when it's followed by the words, "Goes to jail!" In other news, Sunday was daylight savings. Just what we need. One more hour of 2020! Scientists are studying a super beetle that can survive being run over by a car. Or at least that's what the scientist told his kid after he accidentally ran one over. He's fine! He'll pop right back into shape once we're gone. A man in New Hampshire was caught trying to steal $600 worth of merchandise from a sex shop. Police apprehended the man by telling him to stop, drop, and vibrate. Kanye got his wife Kim Kardashian a hologram of her dead father for her birthday. The hologram says that Kim married the most genius man in the whole world, making it the only thing that has endorsed him for president. The most genius man. That's right. Kanye is so genius he doesn't know any synonyms for the word most. It's Election Day, and if you haven't voted yet, go vote so I can stop Googling how to move to New Zealand. I'm Renee Percy. I'll see you next Tuesday for another episode of...
That's our weekly news roundup with Renee Percy. Thank you, Renee. All right, well, the holidays are here. We just had Halloween, and then there's Thanksgiving. Look, we just have to get through this, you know? We're not trying to have any magic moments or like memories that last a lifetime or any of that crap. We just need to live through this, you know? So Christmas is coming. That's going to be fun. Thanksgiving's coming. They say it's going to be a super spreader. I hope they're talking about gravy. But Christmas movies are the thing that I really look forward to year after year. My favorite Christmas movie of all time, Die Hard. Yeah, that's right, Die Hard. A lot of people don't think that's a Christmas movie. It is. It's Bruce Willis, man. He's the best. It's probably one of the best movies ever made. It's so funny, though, that the guys that wrote Die Hard, they had Frank Sinatra in mind for that role. Yeah, Frank. Can you imagine? And he turned it down. He was like, "Look, guys. You got me jumping off some kind of elevator shaft here. Look, I'm not a spring chicken here, kids. I'm 75 frickin' years old." So he turned it down, but he's not the only one. Arnold Schwarzenegger turned it down. Dennis Quaid turned it down. Clint Eastwood turned it down. Clint Eastwood. a role made for Clint, right? Wouldn't you think? Yeah, he turned it down. Who else? Sly Stallone? Sylvester Stallone turned it down? And I often thought about that, what that casting session might have looked like. And it might have looked something like this.
Die Hard. It's pretty good. Yeah, it's good stuff. It's a McClane guy. Yeah, you know.
Okay, Mr. Stallone, if you could take it from page 87 when you're ready.
All right, so. Welcome to the party! Adrian!
Wonderful, wonderful slide.
Amazing.
I love what you did with that.
Wow.
I loved your energy.
It's amazing. Really,
it's quite remarkable, really. Can you give us another read here? Page 87, if you wouldn't mind, Sly. Whenever you're ready.
Yippee-yi-yo, Adrian!
Yes, I agree, but I don't know if this Arnold Schwarzenegger really has a grasp of the English language.
Oh, he'll be fine. We'll just have him grunt.
Ah, true. Who's next?
Clint Eastwood.
Clint Eastwood? Yes.
Oh, hello, Mr. Eastwood.
Hello, what is this crap?
Okay, if you would take it from page 62.
Yes, 62.
Whenever you're ready, Clint.
Yeah, right. Are you gonna call action or just whistle Dixie?
Oh, terribly sorry.
Action.
Welcome to the party, Bunk.
Yes, Clint, brilliant. I love
Excellent.
Your energy. It's tremendous, it's really,
fabulous.
Really striking. Yes. Let's see, do you have any
about we try page 87?
Oh yes, perfect. Mm-hmm. Whenever you're ready, Clint.
Yippee-yi-yo-ki-yay, Bunk.
That was great. That was really, really wonderful.
Well, I don't think that's funny. You're gonna look awfully silly with that pencil sticking out of your ass.
No. I wasn't laughing. It was.
Can I say one more thing? Your mouthwash ain't making it.
Well, thanks for coming, Clint.
Yes, well, yeah, okay. That's just about how every casting session goes in Hollywood these days. Yeah, okay. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. That's my lovely wife, Mara, playing the casting director there, killing it as always. She'll be back, folks, so don't you worry. All right, folks, are you ready for the musical guest of the show today? All right, fasten your seatbelts, because coming to you all the way from Boston is Renegade. Yeah.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman has put an end to my running and I'm so far from my home. Oh, mama, I can hear you crying. You're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows and I don't have very long. Yeah. The jig is up, the news is out, they finally found me. The renegade who had it made, retreat for the bounty. Never more to go astray, this'll be the end today of the wanted man.
Yeah.
Brigade, folks. That's Wayne, Gary, Don, and George. They're all out of Boston, and they all did their musical numbers in their own quarantine environment, and they put it all together for you good folks today. Hope you enjoyed it. All right, well, that's our show for today. Did you dig it, huh? Did you like it? Well, if you did, make sure you subscribe to this channel. I mean it, do it today, because you don't want to miss a moment of what's coming up next. And if you liked it, well, give it a like, share it with a friend, smash it, tell the world about the Quarantine Comedy Show, because we're here for you good people to help you through all this mess. All right, folks, be well, stay cool, and always, always keep laughing. For the Quarantine Comedy Show, I'm Tom Kearney. We'll see you next time.
Coming to you live from the On Access Studios in beautiful downtown Torrance, it's the Quarantine Comedy Show.
I'm ripped!